Hello everyone. So today's session we will discuss on syntax directed tree. In previous session we discussed about SDD. SDD stands for syntax directed definition. In that we discuss which parameters are required for discussion of syntax directed definition. In that we discuss context free grammar, attribute values, as well as attribute values is required for calculation of the syntax directed definition. Also we discuss about there are the two types of the attribute values. First, synthesized attribute value, and second is inherited attribute values. As well as we discuss about the terminal symbols of the grammar are derived from the synthesized attribute and it is not derived from the inherited attributes. Likewise, we discuss about some examples related to syntax directed definition. So today's lecture we discuss about syntax directed tree. So what is the purpose of the syntax directed tree? To visualize the translation specified by an SDD. SDD stands for your syntax directed definition, and that helps to work with parse trees. Means actually visualize the translation process of syntax directed, we require syntax directed tree, and for that we require one kind of a tree is called as a parse tree as well as called as a syntax tree. So the rules of an SDD are applied by first constructing a parse tree and then using the rules to evaluate all the attributes at each of the nodes of the parse tree. Means what here? The semantic rules we have to apply for each and every nodes of that tree. But for that we have to first construct the parse tree, and after that constructing the parse tree, we have to evaluate or we have to calculate the first value of the attributes which are associated with that node, and then we have to calculate the values of the nodes here. So if we construct the tree, that tree is called as a parse tree, and that parse tree showing the value of its attribute is called an annotated parse tree. Means simple, we define the parse tree having a value plus its attribute called as an annotated parse tree. Now question arises, how do we construct an annotated parse tree, as well as in what order do we have evaluate attributes? So before the discussion of that, how we evaluate the attributes and etc. Let we discuss about how we construct the parse tree. So before we can evaluate an attribute at a node of parse tree, we must evaluate all the attributes upon which it value depends. So how we evaluate the value of each and every nodes, or we call each and every attributes, we will discuss further by one example. But remember one thing, that key first we have to find the values of the attributes, and that attributes value we have to use for calculation of the nodes value. So if all attributes are synthesized, means for in previous example we discussed that if all attributes are synthesized, then we must evaluate the val attributes at all of the children of a node before we can evaluate the value attributes at the node itself. Simply, we have to find the value of children nodes attribute, and then we have to move to its parent node. Means we have to use here approach is a bottom up approach. With synthesized attributes, we can evaluate attributes in any bottom up order. For SDDs with both inherited and synthesized attribute, there is no guarantee that there is even one order in which to evaluate attributes at nodes. There is no sequence or no hierarchy when we evaluate inherited or synthesized attributes. Let we discuss one example here, means how we specify the evaluation order or etc. So for instance, consider non-terminals A and B with synthesized and inherited attributes, like A is symbol and S is attribute value, and capital B is also non-terminal symbols associated the values as I respectively, along with the production and rules as like. So this is production, A produces B, and the semantic rule associated that production is A dot S, means attribute A having attribute, non-terminal A having attribute value as S is equals to non-terminal B having its attribute value as I, and that B produces another kind of a production rule, and that production rule having these semantic rules here. So these rules are circular. It is impossible to evaluate other A dot A's at a node n or b dot I at the child of n without first evaluating the order. Means a dot s is repeatedly occurring here. That's why it is a circular and we are not finalized which has first order for evaluation purpose here. So it is computationally difficult to determine whether or not there exist any circularities in any of the parse trees that given STD would have to translate. Means we are not determined whether or not there exist any circularities in our STD or not here. So next, let me discuss one example, means how we construct the syntax directed tree for the given production rule and attribute values here. So we have to construct the annotated parse tree for the expression 3 plus 5 plus 4 n by using the productions of the previous example. Previous example of production is likewise key L produces E n, E produces E plus T, also E produces the T. Likewise, in previous session we discussed key how we write the production and according to that production how we write the semantic rules, already we discussed that. So by using that production rule and the semantic rule, now we have to discuss how we construct the syntax directed tree for the given expression 3 star 5 plus 4 into n. So before we have to write add the attribute values and etc., first we have to draw the syntax tree as a top down order manner. So we have to calculate 3 star 5 plus 4 n. So let we start from the L dot value is our first symbol plus its attribute value. That L dot val derives E dot val, that E dot, so and we call key E produces E plus T, E produces then again T, that T produces T star F, T produces F, and F produces the non-terminal symbol as a digit. Likewise, that F produces terminal symbol digit. And right hand side T produces F, F produces digit here. So this is our syntax tree here, also called key parse tree. For each and every node we just assign its values. Now we have to convert that parse tree into annotated parse tree for the 3 star 5 plus 4 n in the bottom of order. So digit dot lx value is equals to 3. So lex value is calculated directly from lexical analyzer, and we have, for the discussion we have to assume that key this value is calculated from the lexical analyzer. So lexical analyzer is equals to 3 means we have to assign value for this terminal symbol as a 3 directly from lexical analyzer. That value we have to pass to its parent. That parent gives to t dot val is equals to 3. Likewise, digit dot lex value is equals to 5. That value we have to pass to its parent f dot val. So the t dot val value is calculated from t dot val is equals to 3 and f dot val is equals to 5. By applying this star function, we calculate the value for the t dot val, and that value we have to pass to e dot value. Same way, we have to write this hierarchy at the rightmost part here, and e dot val. Finally, we have to calculate by e dot val 15 value and t dot val as a 4 value. By applying the plus operator, we got the final value as 19. So this n is nothing but the end marker. Already we discussed about that here. So this simple tree defines attribute values as well as the non-terminals by using the tree. And that tree we call this the annotated tree. First, we have to construct the parse tree. For that parse tree, we have to assign attribute values. And we calculate that at values by bottom up manner, and that tree we called as annotated parse tree. So this is description for that our diagram. So this figure shows annotated parse tree for the input string 3 star plus 5 4 n, n is nothing but the end marker, constructed using this grammar and rules of first example. The value of lex value, or we just assume that key is supplied by lexical analyzer. Already we discussed that. Each of the nodes are for the non-terminals has attribute value computed in bottom-up order manner. For instance, at the node with child label star, after computing t value 3 and f value 5 at it first and the third children, we apply the rule that says t colon val is the product of these two values or 15. Already we discussed that here.